Yeah, as far from a criminal point of view, it was clearly the most important case I was involved in. In fact, I was only involved in it for one night, and it was when I was a relatively new patrol officer. It was 1976 or 1977. I was working midnights, and earlier in the day, an individual by the name of Lemuel Smith had kidnapped at gunpoint a young woman from an office in Schenectady, and had forced her to drive him up to an abandoned home in Saratoga County, where he brutally assaulted her over a period of time, and then decided to once again have her drive the two of them down towards Albany. And back then, people were thinking that he was probably going to take her someplace, kill her, and dump the body. But what had happened was that when that young woman didn't show up home from work on this particular day, her parents reported her missing to the police. One of the things that the police department did was that they gave the information on this case to a citizens band radio network, which began broadcasting the information about the missing person and her car regularly over the citizens band radio network. And about 11 o'clock at night, when me and other members of the Colonie Police Department were getting ready to go on the road, a young couple was sitting in their home listening to this broadcast from a citizens band radio network about a missing woman. And between the two of them, they decided that they had to try and help find this woman. And the gentleman from that couple actually left his house, got in his car, drove about one block onto Central Avenue near the Niskayuna-Colonie border, and they saw this car belonging to this woman who had been reported missing earlier in the day, driving eastbound on Central Avenue, moving into the town of Colonie. Right about at the same time, I was going out on the road for the midnight shift. We had a two-man car that night. It was myself driving and another police officer by the name of Bill Lockhart. This car did in fact come by us, and we immediately pulled out behind it. I was driving, Bill was in the passenger seat. We pulled it over. Remember, I approached the driver and he went up on the passenger side. At the very same time, another Colonie police car, who was just backing us up, they pulled in with us, and that was Dave McCall and Rich Gerard. But I remember as I got up to the car, a woman, she was, for obvious reasons, getting pretty upset. And I took her out of the car and began walking her back to the police car, and I give her so much credit in the world, because she, as upset as she was, and despite the ordeal that she went through, she was still managing to tell us to look out, he's got a gun. He had, in fact, ditched the gun at some point since they got in the car the last time. But my partner Lockhart went up and talked to Lemuel Smith, who had been in the passenger seat, and he claimed that it was his girlfriend, and she was just making this stuff up because they were of different races. But there were some articles in the car. There were some ropes and things that he had used to tie her up. And based on, you know, everything we had that night, we decided to bring everybody into the police station. And once we got in there, it became clear that Lemuel Smith was a suspect in some other very, very serious crimes in the Albany area. He was a serial killer, as it turns out. He had killed one elderly couple in a religious store in the city of Albany in about a year prior to when we encountered him. Another time he managed to abduct a young woman out of a store at Colonie Center, a pretty large shopping mall in the area, and took her out to her car where he just brutally murdered this woman. Unfortunately, he did not get the death penalty. He obviously should have. He's still alive in a New York State prison someplace, filing frivolous lawsuits against the residents of the state. So he was obviously the worst person, and from a criminal point of view, that was the most serious case that I was ever involved in.
Lemuel Smith's criminal record started when he was about 17. According to published reports, Smith was implicated, though not arrested at the time, in the 1958 robbery murder of Dorothy Water Street in Amsterdam, New York. During the summer of that same year, while police were continuing the Amsterdam investigation, Smith moved to Baltimore, Maryland, where he reportedly abducted a 25-year-old woman, nearly killing her. The assault was interrupted, and Smith was sentenced to 20 years for assault. He was paroled after 10 and moved back to the Albany area. In May 1969, Smith kidnapped and sexually assaulted a woman who managed to escape. Later that same day, he kidnapped and raped a 46-year-old friend of his mother's. When the woman convinced Smith to let her go, he was arrested again and eventually sentenced 4 to 15 in a New York prison. 1976, Robert Hederman and Hederman's secretary, Margaret Byron, were found brutally murdered in the back of Hederman's religious store in Albany. 1 month later, while Albany police were investigating the double murder, Joan Richburg, age 24, was raped, murdered, and mutilated in her car at the Colonie Center Mall. In the summer of 1977, Mary Lee Wilson was found strangled and mutilated near the train tracks in downtown Schenectady. A month later, Marianne Maggio, age 18, who worked in the same area as Mary Lee, was kidnapped and raped by Lemuel Smith. When he forced her to drive toward Albany afterward, it was John Grebert and Bill Lockhart who stopped the car. March 1978, Smith confessed to 5 murders, including the murder of Dorothy Water Street in Amsterdam nearly 20 years before. Smith received sentences of 10 to 20, 25 to life, and 50 to life, but his crimes did not end while in prison. In 1981, Smith killed a female prison guard, Donna Payant. At that time, the crime carried the death penalty, but was commuted to another life sentence.
That's the thing. It's being in the right place at the right time, which, as anyone involved in law enforcement knows, a lot of times that's all that makes the difference between someone's life, you know, being saved and someone losing their life. So we felt good about it, but we probably didn't realize for some time after that night just how serious of a criminal Lemuel Smith was. And, you know, the fact that this woman who was probably doomed to a terrible death, you know, without this couple in Niskayuna who took it upon themselves to intervene in the situation, about 11 o'clock on a Friday night.